Hi everyone, it's Bianca here. Welcome to this tutorial. What do you think of this cactus lampshade? Isn't it cute? I'm going to explain step by step how to make these. But first, what do we need all for this lamp? I'm using two different colors of green yarn from Scheepjes, Katona, balls from 50 grams. We need a crochet hook between the 2.5 and 3.5 millimeter. I'm using a 2.5 millimeter crochet hook. We need also a needle and scissors. And then we need also a lampshade, and I buy this by IKEA. You also need the connection of the lamp. This one here. So, let's get started. I work with two colors of green yarn, and I start with the lighter color, and then we make a slip knot on the hook, and then we have to make chain stitches, 92 in total. Yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through. I have here 4 chain stitches. It must be 92. Work all your chain stitches till you have 92 chain stitches, and then I'll see you back for the first row. I made 92 chain stitches, and we start on row 1. We skip the first 3 chain stitches from the hook. That's 1, 2, 3, and then into the next stitch make 1 double crochet, yarn over, enter hook in that 4th chain stitch, make 1 double crochet. So we have here 2 double crochets. That chain 3 here in the beginning counts also for 1 double crochet. Make a chain 2. Now skip the next 2 chain stitches. This is the stitch where we're working in. Then 1 and 2. Then in the 3rd chain, we make 1 double crochet. And also 1 double crochet into the next stitch. So we have again 2 double crochets. Make a chain 2. Skip the next 2 chain stitches. 1 and 2, into the next stitch, 1 double crochet, and in the next stitch, also 1 double crochet. And this is the repeat. You work all the way across to the end of this row, make a chain 2, skip the next 2 chain stitches, into the next 2 chain stitches, make 1 double crochet in each stitch. And then a chain 2. Work like this all the way to the end. I'm almost on the end of this first row. I have here 4 chain stitches left over. You make a chain 2, skip 2 chain stitches, and then in the last 2 chain stitches you work also 1 double crochet. And the first row is complete. Here in the first row we have 23 times 2 double crochets with between and chain 2. Row 2, we start with a chain 3. 1, 2, 3 counts for a first double crochet. Now you turn your work upside down, and now we have to skip that first double crochet. To skip that first double crochet, you have to make and chain two more. It's one and two to create a chain two space. Now skip that double crochet, and in the chain two space, we make two double crochets in that space. Yarn over in that chain two, work around that chain two in that space, and make two doubles in that space. One and two. Now you see here on the top of the two double crochets, we work here only one double crochet. Make a chain two, skip then the next two double crochets, and then in the next chain two space, make again two double crochet. That's one and two. And this is the repeat. You work all the way across to the end. Make a chain two, skip the next two double crochets, in the next chain two space, two double crochets. It's one and two. Work like this, all the stitches. In the last chain two space, make also two double crochet. Then in chain two, now we skip here the last double crochet, and then on the top of the first double crochet, that's the chain three, in the third chain stitch, make also one double crochet. It's one, two, and three in that chain stitch. Then you go to two loops, grab your yarn, and make one double crochet on the top of that first chain three. So we have here also on the end, above that two double crochets, only one double crochet. I made this last double crochet complete, but I want to change from color. So I grab my next color and I pull one stitch out, that last double crochet. I want to show you how I change from color. So yarn over, and the hook in the top of that chain three, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and pull through two. Now you stop. You make that double crochet not complete with the first color. You go to the second color, yarn over, and then pull through two loops on the hook. Yeah. Now we're on the back. I make a little knot to secure that new color. So, and once more. We don't have to cut this lighter color. So we can start with row three with the new color, the dark green. Row three with the darker green color, and we start with a chain three, counts for a first double crochet. Now you turn your work. Now we create here in the first chain two space one double crochet. So we have here on top of the one double crochet two double crochets. So we start here in the beginning with two double crochets, then the next row is one double crochet, the next row is two double crochets. Make a chain two, then skip the next two double crochets, in the next chain two space make two new double crochet. And this is also the repeat. You work all the way across to the end of this row. Then on the end, if you work all your stitches, here in that space for the last space, you work two double crochets, then a chain two, one double crochet in that last chain 5 space, and then on the top of the third chain stitch you work also one double crochet, but I'll show you the end. The end of this third row, skip the last two double crochets, then in the chain 5 space one double crochet, and also one double crochet on the top of the first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch. 1, 2, 3. And you go to 2 loops and then make on top the last double crochet. Also on this side we begin here with 2 double crochets, then on top 1 double crochet, on top 2 double crochets. The next row with the same color, we begin with a chain 3, counts for a first double crochet. Turn your work, now we have to skip that first double crochet here. We have to make only one double crochet on top of a 2 double crochets here. To skip over that double crochet you have to make 2 more chain stitches. Now you start all over again with the same repeat. In the next chain 2 space, make 2 double crochet in that space, make a chain 2, skip 2 double crochet, and then in the next chain 2 space 2 double crochets all the way across to the end at the same way. On the end of this row, you make 2 double crochets in that last chain 2 space. Now make chain 2. Now you work here on top of that first chain 3. So we skip the next double crochet, and then in the top of the first double crochet, that's the chain 3, in the third chain stitch, we work also one double crochet. And also we change from color. Yarn over, enter hook in that top of that chain 3. Now that next color here, you bring up to the high of your hook, so like this. Then with the dark green color, you yarn over and pull through. So we attach that light green color here on the top of that chain 3. Make a yarn over and pull through 2. So you have 2 loops on the hook with the dark green color. So we grab our light green color, yarning over, and then pull through 2 loops. Now we change from color. And then we can start all over again. At the same way, make a chain 3, counts for a first double crochet. Now you turn your work. And then we go further with the light green color. We don't cut the dark green color. In the first chain 2 space we make 1 double crochet, so we create 2 double crochets on top of the first double crochet. And then you work again a chain 2, skip 2 double crochets, and then in the next chain 2 space make 2 doubles all the way across to the end. On the end of this row, we make after the last 2 double crochets here in that space of the chain 2, a chain 2, then we skip the last 2 double crochets here, and then in that chain 5 space 1 double crochet, and then here on the top of the 1 double crochet of that chain 3 in the third chain stitch, 1, 2, 3, in that stitch you go under 2, 2, and 2 loops, so like this. Make 1 double crochet on top of that one double crochet. So we have also a group of two double crochets on top of one double crochet. Make a chain three, and then we begin all over again. We turn our work. Then we skip the first double crochet here after the chain three to make a chain two. So we work in the beginning on the top of two double crochets and chain five. Then in that chain two space, you work two double crochets in that space, and then you start all over again with the repeat. Also here, we have here on top of two double crochets, one double crochet. See? It's two double crochet, one double crochet, two double crochet, one double crochet, two double crochet, one double crochet. Also, we make 23 times boxes of two double crochets in that same chain two space. Work like this, on and on and on. And on and on and on till you have 72 rows in total. The last row is a dark green color, and you see here all these loops from changing colors. We want those loops on the inside of our work. Now you fold your work together in half. So like this, you see, in half. Now we work both sides together with single crochet stitches. Zoom in a little bit closer that you can see what I'm doing. Here on the top of that double crochet, and you see here that first row we have a chain five. Now in the third chain stitch, you go in with your hook. It's one, two, three. That stitch here, you go in with your hook, and then grab your yarn. Pull through one loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through two. Now here in that chain two space of this side and also on the under through that side here on the back, under through two chain two spaces, you work two single crochets in that space. That's one and two. Now on the next double crochet, you go under through that double crochet and also that double crochet here on the back. Like this, under through two rows here, grab your yarn, pull up and make one single crochet. Also on the top of the next double crochet and here on the back, double crochet in the chain two spaces, in the front and in the back, under through two loops, make two single crochets. And this is the repeat. You work all the way across to the end. Work like this all your single crochet stitches. I made all the single crochet stitches. Then on the end we make one chain to make a little knot, loop, then cut the yarn, wave the tail in, and then work, fold your work inside out. We are going to make basting stitches
with a thread and needle to make our work fit around the lamp later. On top, here, and also on the other side, all the way around. I take the light color green and measure the 3 times the width of our work. And then I cut the yarn and I grab the needle. I'm done on both sides and I grab the lampshade and slide it in through our work. Pull both threads to fit around the lamp and make small stitches with the same thread to secure our work to the lamp. Do this also on the other side. And then this is the end result. Let's make 2 cactus flowers. We have to create 2 cactus flowers. Spread the flower here. We make this in 2 different colors. And in the first flower, I start here with the light green color. The second flower, we start with the dark green color. Make a magic circle on the hook. Make a chain 1, counts for nothing, it's only to high up a stitch. Now here in the magic circle you make 8 half double crochets. Yarn over, enter your hook in the magic circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through all the loops. That's 1, 8 in total. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now pull on the short tail to close the magic circle and now you can cut the yarn. Open that last stitch to pull your hook all the way up. Now I grab a needle.
goes to the needle. We make an invisible join in the beginning. We skip the first chain, then the first half double crochet. You go to the next half double crochet under to that V stitch. Then pull through to the back. You go to the last stitch, that's the half double crochet number 8. You go only in that back loop and then pull through. Wave both tails in on the back of the stitches and pull that tail of the magic circle to close that gap here in the middle. All the way around we made 8 half double crochets. In each stitch we make 1 flower petal. 8 flower petals in total. We go to the pink color and we make a slip knot on the hook and then a slip stitch through one of the stitches on top, under through that V. Grab your yarn, pull up and pull up. Pull through. After that slip stitch we make 8 chain stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Now we skip here the first chain stitch from the hook and into the next 7 chain stitches we pull up a loop. You skip the first, you go to the second, into that stitch, grab your yarn and pull a loop. Go to the next stitch. Into that stitch, grab your yarn and pull a loop. Into the next, 7 times in total. That's number 3, into the next stitch. 4, in the next. 5, into the next stitch. 6, and in your first chain stitch. That's number 7. So you have 8 loops on the hook. Now we yarn over and pull through the first 2 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through the next 2 loops on the hook. Yarn over and pull through 2. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, pull through 2. And yarn over and pull through the last 2 loops on the hook. So we have this. Now here, after that chain here, you see this little loop here. This loop here. You go under through that loop. And then grab your yarn. Pull up and then make 1 single crochet. Yarn over. Pull through 2. We go to the next loop. This loop here. Go under through that loop here on the front. Grab your yarn. Pull up. Yarn over. Pull through 2 for a single crochet. Under through the next loop. Under through that stitch. Make 1 single crochet. That's 3. The next. 4 single crochets, the next loop, 5 single crochets, and once more, the last loop here, 6 single crochets, and then here on the first chain stitch, you work also 1 single crochet, that's number 7. This is the stitch where we're working in. You go to the next stitch of the next half double crochet and work 1 slip stitch. And your first flower petal is complete. We work 7 more again all the way around. I'll show you the flower petal once more. We start after that chain stitch, after that slip stitch, 8 chain stitches. So 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now we skip the first chain stitch from the hook, and then in the next 7 chain stitches we pick up a loop. That's 1, into the next, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So we have 8 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pulled for 2, yarn over, pulled for 2, yarn over, pulled for 2. So you have on the end of these stitches 1 stitch left on the hook. The stitch here, you go under through and work 1 single crochet. That's 1, 6 in total. The next is 2, 3, 4, 5, and the last here, that's number 6. And then we have to make also 1 single crochet here in the first chain stitch. That's number 7. This is the stitch where we're working in. Into the next half double crochet, you work 1 slip stitch. 2 flower petals complete. Make 6 more all the way around. When you're done with flower petal number 8, then we cut the yarn, open that last stitch, then I grab the needle, then you go with the needle to that first chain stitch here, that's a slip stitch here in the beginning. So on top, like this, then pull through the back. Now make a little knot on the back of the flower and weave both tails in. Now we have to make the stems of the flower. Here in that first flower, I start with the light green and I make stems of the same color of the flower petals, but I make also here in the darker green also the stems of the flower. So here the second flower, we start with the dark green in the center, so we have to make stems in the light green color and the same color of the flower. You cut 10 pieces of yarn, 5 strands of the light green color and 5 strands of the pink color, about the size of your hook. Then on the top of 1 strand of yarn, we make a little knot all the way up to the end. So all the way here on the top, you make a little knot here on the end. So you do this also to the next 9 pieces of yarn. I grab the needle and 1 piece of thread. Here's your little knot, and then on the other side we put that yarn through that needle. And then you go with your needle to the center of the flower and pull through till you have the thread on the size that you want. So like this. Then you hold your thread to the front, turn your flower, then you make 1 little knot on the back. spool. Then you can cut the yarn very short, like this, so you have one stamp here on the front. And we do this at the same with the next 9 stamps. So the second, you hold this stamp here to the center of the flower at the same level with the second stamp, like this. Turn your flower on the back, you make a little knot, under to one little stitch, once more. Then you go 2 times through a loop here on the back. Then pull to create a little knot and cut off that yarn. Do this also with the 8 other pieces of thread. I'm done with the 2 flowers and this is the end result. All these little knots on the back of the flower in 2 different colors. Now with a thread and a needle, using small stitches, sew the flowers onto the cactus wherever you want. And then the lamp is complete. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Click on the notification bell so you don't miss any new tutorial from me. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye!